A pleasant good evening and welcome to the program Hit Wiz Show on Youth Tunes. So if you're just joining us, it's a pleasant welcome to this edition of the show. Today is July 23rd, 2022. My name is William McGill, Willie Will, and I'm your host on the show. It's a pleasant welcome to all of you today on the program. We will definitely be playing host to our guest. He's Quitty Billy. His artistic name is Yo QB. He's our guest for today. We're definitely going to be talking about his music. He's a Liberian upcoming artist, and he's doing great when it comes to music, when it comes to his music. And he's doing extremely well. So if you're watching us and just joining us, we ask that you share this live video, sharing all of the video part of, and we will definitely come up with our guest to talk about his music, his artistic career, what inspired him to become an artist, most especially in the Liberian music industry. And you know, why is it important to be an artist in such a space? What are those challenges he's been faced with in order to get this done? And what's the courage? A lot more we're gonna talk. Don't miss out on the show, as we will definitely come up with your QB as our guest onto this presentation. So stay tuned, folks, and remember to share this live coverage as we have your QB on as our guest shortly. So his song is in the description there. We already pinned the link on the profile. All you can do for yourself is to definitely click on the link on the live coverage, and you're definitely gonna be a part of the Yo QB pin where you can get his music. You can listen to his music, and don't forget to subscribe to his YouTube channel as well. So this link that I posted in the caption down is on the screen there. You can get his YouTube, Audio Mark, his whatever platform his music is being posted on. So let's say a pleasant good evening from Liberia, QB.
Oh, what's good? How you doing, man?
We're good, bro. How's everything? How's life?
Life is great, you know. We can't complain. Life good, you know, we can't complain.
Okay. So someone watching would like to know who is your QB when this all started in terms of getting involved into music.
I'll say your QB is somebody, like, you know what I mean, that like making people, you know what I mean, happy. And I like seeing people dance when it comes to music. Why? I like putting a smile on people's face, you know. And somebody like to do more, you know what I mean? Just love to do more for other people and stuff. So the way in which I feel like I can express my feelings to people is like doing music, you know what I mean? Because I feel like doing music, more people can relate to other things. So you'll keep it somebody that like to make people smile and just like seeing people happy in general right now.
Okay. Love to make people smile, people happy in general as well. Now, you like to tell us, since when, you know, you joined the music industry, since when you started recording your song, you got involved into music?
Oh, I started recording music since 2018. I recorded my first song in Philly 2018 when I was in high school.
Okay, 2018. How has it been like since 2018? And what have been your biggest motivation?
Since 2018, I feel like my music been getting better every time, you know. It's just all about the sound, you know. And once you, like, you feel like, you know, the more you do music, the more you get to realize that same way your music used to sound back then, and when you listen to your songs now, you know what I mean? It gave you know what I mean, more encouragement. And my, like, you know, music for me, music is something that I've been holding on since I was a kid, you know. Music always been the way for me. even regardless with family, with other stuff, but music always been my therapy, you know what I mean? So I feel like whenever I'm in trouble or going through a lot of stuff, I go to music instead of going to other people. I write music and stuff. So yeah.
Who's your role model when it comes to doing music?
When it comes to doing music, my role model is Wizboy. Yeah, Wizboy from Nigeria.
Wizboy.
Yeah.
Yeah, I know. So now let's talk about your inspiration. How do you get inspired to write about these lyrics and put a topic together, go into the booth, spit bars, you know, put out these lyrics?
You know, I would say, like, it's not like, I don't know how, but for me, I feel like I'm as I told you before, music is something I love doing. So me personally, I don't just, it's just based on the music vibes, the beats, and then the more I'm in, you know what I mean? So it's just like, it's not like I gotta wait for some inspiration to do music. No, like something that I love to do. So once I'm having fun, I'm doing something, you know?
Now, you've been doing music since 2018. What have been one song that you released and you started getting tons of complaints from people that support your brand?
I'll say one of my songs that I recorded that gave me like more people to start listening to my song was African Lady.
African Lady,
yeah.
And how did you get inspired with that song?
African Lady, you know, I would say this. The reason I love African Lady is because I was in a music band before I even came out African Lady. And then, you know, I couldn't write a song alone. That was my first thing, right? So, well, African Lady, how I got inspired by that song, I was at work. And then I would just listen to a beat and then, you know, I mean, just started thinking, and I'm like, if I'm talking to a girl and then trying to express it, you know, just come so like that. And then I said, like, I'm on the vibe. I'm like, okay, I like the vibe. And I was in the car with my mom. So I was playing the beat. And then I said, she was like, it's good. Just keep doing what you're doing. And then I started getting inspiration for that song. And since then, I said, people started rapping on my songs.
Okay. So now, let's talk about challenges. How do it feel like to be involved, to be part of the Liberian music industry? How do it feel as an artist?
I'll say it's something that right now is hard to deal with because in order to understand like the industry is growing too, so everybody gotta grow along with the industry, you know? You don't wanna stay back. But the thing is, the more we try to, like, we the artists that based in the diasporas, the more we try to do the work and put the work out there for the, like, for our people back on the list, you know, it's kind of hard because, you know, people say, oh, I'm not on Tones Libera, you're not on the one, so, and they don't understand the process we go through to put our songs on Tones Libera, you know, and other platforms in Liberia. It's hard for us to do that because they feel like we down here, we're making all the money. So, and if they don't realize that we make down here, like, you know what I mean? We got all the people down here. So the songs we're doing, it's only for like a certain group of people. And I'm going to just say, I'm saying like in general, it's hard. You know what I mean? It's hard. And I understand that the industry is growing. So it'll get, times will come, like things will get harder for you as an artist that don't make it for us, a lot of industry. But it's only based on how you handle your situations and what you keep doing, you know?
And now let's talk about your challenges and one of your biggest fears as an artist. What are those challenges?
Can you say that again?
Your challenges, you know, what are those challenges you go through as an artist to get into the studio, record a song, write a song, get a beat, you know?
It's all about the, you know what I mean, the work and the money. Once you get money, you know what I mean, as an artist, you can, your steps. Once you get money as an artist, you know what I mean, you can be able to get beats, you can be able to get a ghostwriter, you can be able to get everything. But as an upcoming artist, it's more challenging because you gotta work and get the money, gotta go to the studio and pay for a couple of hours. You gotta understand you're working and then you at work, you wanna rehearsal your song before you go to the studio, and now because you don't wanna go to the studio and then you miss the stuff. I come, okay? You miss the stuff. It's like y'all keep working and keep doing your songs and stuff. So it's more challenging, you know, because you need money, studio time, and time to focus on your songs.
Have you been signed to a record label? Do you have a team that you're working with to push your brand, which is essential for any artist?
Oh, for me right now, no, I won't say that because it's just me. I'm doing everything for myself right now, and I'm working. Don't get me wrong. I had a couple proposals, like people want to manage me, but the thing is, you gotta understand. For me, I'm a person that love to like. I don't believe in people money. I don't believe in taking people money because I want you to be my manager. I don't believe in all that. Your passion, you know what I mean? Your passion can move me, you know what I mean? Because once we both got the same passion for what I'm doing, I feel like it's more benefiting than putting more money in, you feel me? Because we both can work to one goal and stuff.
One goal. So, why if a record label wants to sign you, what are you expecting from such label?
If a record label trying to sign me, I'm expecting you to do a thing that I can't do for myself in 6 months. You know, what's so much thing you can do for me that I feel like I can't do for myself? Because the thing is, my mindset is I don't just want to be a librarian artist. You feel me? I want to be like.
Okay. Okay.
This is my career, so I want to be global. So if you can't make that happen for me, so what the answer me signing with you?
Global and making it an essential part of your career, you know. So now let's talk about some of your projects. Have you been opportunity to collaborate with other artists? Is it easier doing it as a lone artist, as you said, you are all alone?
Doing a collaboration hard, you know, it's not that hard. It's just based on the artist that you're doing the song with, you know. For me, I'm telling you right now, I got a couple of songs in my phone that I haven't even touched yet. Because, you know what I mean? Once the song is good and it's best, like, the inspiration on the whole thing is balanced, you know what I mean? Y'all can come to one simple grind, you know what I mean? And other artists, like, you know what I mean, collaboration stuff. The only way the song going to be hard is that the person that you're doing a collaboration with don't know what they're doing. You feel me? Then, you know what I mean? Then you can hang your head and start doing everything there. But, you feel me? Once the artist is good, he know what he or she doing. And come on, it'd be fun.
Are there plans on dropping an album or an EP very soon?
I would say yes. I plan on dropping an EP, but you know, it's more about me building and saying things, you know what I mean? Cause it's all about if I work with a new producer, then they look at my previous work and my, you know what I mean, my work right now, be like, we gotta do this, we gotta do that, cause I like to listen to other things, you know what I mean? So I'm working on an EP, yes, I'm working on an EP, but I will not drop it right now and that, not like that, you know what I mean?
Okay, so if you just joined us, you're watching the Hit Wiz show on YouTube Tunes, and I'm your host. We have your guest, YoQD, he's here, and we have his link to all of his social and a streaming platform for his music. It's been pinned on our streams. You can get there and, you know, listen to his songs. It's good. Now let's talk about some of your music. You just released your recent song, Lonely Love. Let's talk about the topic. How did you got inspired with the topic, Lonely Love?
Oh, Lonely Love. All right, so... so, Lonely Love, like, it was this one morning, and I was on my way to work. And then, you know Benny Song, right? So, he sent me the beat.
Yeah, Benny Song, from Nigeria.
Yeah, he sent me the beat. So I was listening, and I was on my way to where I listened to the beat. So at a time, so what happened was, I just had one of my friends just broke up with her girlfriend. So we was driving, and then we're drinking liquor. Everybody drinking liquor the whole drive, you know what I mean? So, and then with me too, I had a little problem, you know what I mean? I had a little problem. So I'm like, and then with that, both of that vibe, you know what I mean? Just came up together and just make a head of vibe, you know what I mean? We're learning love. And me come out like, you know what I mean? Putting my feelings in a song, taking other people's feelings and putting the song, you know what I mean? I just like came out with that song.
How was it like working with an international producer for Nigeria?
Bro, it's fun, bro. I ain't gonna hold you. Like, it's fun. It's hella fun. And one thing about working with Benny Sound, bro, like, and I would say that I wish I could work with him, like earlier, you know what I mean, in my music career, or like earlier than now. But, bro, it's fun. And the thing about Benny Sound, he's well understanding then, you know what I mean? The other thing, he gonna tell you, gonna be like, yo, how you do this one? I don't really like it. I want you to do it, like, you know what I mean? You can do better, you know what I mean? So the people that you need around you, you know, and stuff. Yeah.
And let's talk about strategies. Now, I've been told you might be having a challenge for Lonely Love soon. What is the challenge all about? Could you mind to tell us a bit about it?
Yeah, Lonely Love challenge would be, it will be dropping soon. And the challenge all about being creative, you know what I mean? If you can sing, you sing. If you can dance, you dance. Just got to be creative with the challenge, you know what I mean? All you got to do your video, send it to me. I post it on my Facebook page, and then you go, you tell your friends and friends to share. The person with the best share and comments and stuff. I'm not going to pick the winner, you know what I mean? The public going to do it. So you just got to be creative with your work, you know what I mean? That's all.
Okay, creativity involves. And hopefully, let's talk about, is it easy? Like, I've been hearing a lot of other artists back in the U.S. talking about it's tough, you know, it's not easy to get my craft being pushed in Liberia. What are some of those challenges do you face to promote your work back in Liberia?
Yeah, as I told you before, you know, I mean, To post your work back home in Liberia is hard, you know what I mean? That's all this based in the U.S., you know what I mean? Not mean in the U.S., in the diaspora, you know what I mean? Because people back home feel like you're making all the money here, so the moment you try reaching out to them, they're gonna do like, oh, yeah, my man, you're making all the money, so you got to give me this one, you give me that one, and then we take this one, you know what I mean? And we're all there, bro. You gotta understand, we from Liberia and we got people back home. Even cut out the people stuff, right? Treat us like we all are brothers, you know what I mean? We all like doing the same thing. Even if you take $10 from me, even if you take, all right, let's say you take $10 from the person in Liberia, even if you take $20 from me, you know what I mean? It doesn't matter. But you can say, you can take $10 from the man in Liberia and can't take $200 from me. Like, you know, the thing I need to make people understand, like, bro, right? I need to make people understand, like,
the reason that, man, I say y'all making plenty of money.
Nah, bro, they didn't understand because they just say the name of the money. They just say it, and then they don't really think about how you get the money. They just say the money. Bro, let me get $200 for you, Jeff, for money or something. Nigga, what? I can't do that. How you going to do it? What's your money here? You feel me? And even if you give them your money, you feel me? I can say this. It's not everybody in Liberia doing that, but like, you know what I mean? My Jerry telling niggas doing it. You know what I mean? Even if you give them your money, they won't do your work for you. At the end of the day, they'll be like, oh, bro, all the stuff. So now they're making, we the artists not in Liberia, we the artists, the Liberian artists based in the diaspora. Why is it we can't just take our stuff to different people and then they promote it for us?
Yeah.
It's just saying Africa is not that because you Liberian that your music force supply in Liberia. No, like it's in Africa. Like, yeah. Liberia still gonna listen when we're out of Liberia. And once you stop playing, people other country vibing to it. Did St. Liberia people go download it?
So now, you've been in the U.S. for years and been doing music there. How is it like? Have you been on occasions on shows? Have you performed? have been the response from fans in the diaspora there concerning your work?
Yeah, man, like I perform a couple of shows and stuff, weddings and stuff, you know what I mean? And whenever I go perform, people always tell me, like, you got a good sound. I like your song. I like your song. You know what I mean? Your songs can be played anywhere. Because my thing is my music, I don't really be using swear words in my music. I don't curse. I don't do all the extra stuff because I want for young folks to relate to my song and also for like old people to relate to my song. So I feel like if I'm doing this song for the group of people, I'll do this song for them. But if I'm doing stuff for both people, like, I mean, I gotta make sure that, you know what I mean, there's no swear word in there like that, you know what I mean? Even if I say something, it should be slick something, you know what I mean? But that's something I'll be 24-hour cussing. But whenever I go perform my song, people always come in like, oh, I like your song. What's your name? Oh, da-da-da, and stuff, you know?
I just sometimes feels like quitting. I want to quit music. I'm not finding myself in this place. I want to quit. Do you sometimes feels like because you don't get the kind of support you need?
This is the only thing I hold on. So I can't quit music, regardless of my situation. Music is the only thing that carried me through in life. So I can't quit music.
I love that. I can't quit music. Now let's talk about some of your dreams. What are some of those, or who are some of those artists that you dream of featuring, maybe back in Liberia, internationally, that you think of working with in time to come?
Back in Liberia, right now. I'm not being rude, but right now, I would say I'm not ready. If I'm thinking about somebody to do a song with, it'll be out of Bakura or Kobayashi.
Okay.
All right. So, but so ready, you know what I mean? But internationally, I would say Wizboy. I would say DeVito. I would say Chris Brown. I would say The Baby, you know what I mean? Big artists, you know what I mean? Big other artists, you know what I mean? Just to make sure that my country's out there, because once I'm out there, I'm representing my country. So, you know what I mean? I'm just thinking big.
Okay. Now, where to QB hope of seeing his musical career in the next 3 to 4 years as we move on?
I want to win a Grammy.
I love that. I want to win a Grammy.
I want to win a Grammy, bro. That's my. And it's not. I want to. I know I'm gonna win a Grammy. So I'm working every day. I'm working on my music, on my craft every day. I know I'm definitely gonna win a Grammy,
okay,
man.
Okay. Do you think it's easy as a lone artist to get things done? You know, it's almost like a toting a whole brand, and you gotta be a PR or promoter. You strategize your own promotion stuff, reach out to people by yourself. You get booked, you know, for even through yourself and everything. It's easy.
It's not easy. It's not easy. It's hard. You know what I mean? It's hard. As a like lone artist, it's hard. Like it's hard to do everything. You know, it's hard to get everything done. Most of the time, you always get some stuff like, yeah, I mean, get done with that, yeah, you're still trying to get another stuff because I understand. Got to keep doing work. You got to keep working over and over because you can't just stop one where you got to keep doing the work. If it's not done, you got to get another one and make sure that you come back to that the moment you take the other one in the middle. So it's hard. I'm going to be honest with you. It's hard because you gotta understand one thing as an artist. If people come in directly to you to book you, the price they will give you is different than when they go into your management team.
Okay.
Because if somebody want to book you, they can go to a management team. That will be, you know, they will discuss that with the management, but they will see you like more advanced. But if they just come to you directly to book you, you know, people mindset be like, yeah, you know what I mean? It's not managed by nobody. So even when I get anything, you will hold it, you know what I mean? Something like that.
Yeah, like my own brother, man. So then I say, but I'm my own brother, man. And, you know, you can reach out anything. So now, do you see competition in the music industry, most especially in Liberia?
Do I see a competition in general or something?
Yeah, generally.
In the library industry, it's always a competition in every industry, you know what I mean? And even anywhere in the world, like the music industry, everywhere in the world, there's gotta be a competition in order for people to be able to well advance themselves, you know what I mean? But with the library industry, it's not, I'm not really saying like a competition. I feel like people go to certain level and just realize if people reach the same, if you like this and then you come this little far, what you
So
do is you just,
it's like when they have a play song, when they have a play song, then relax and feel complacent about knowing more
they just feel like
and getting where they
one
want to
hit
get.
songs, you know what I mean? And when they do one